in academics, pharmaceutical business, link management, and in the bureaucratic role of for overall 15 plus years as a professional experience, and 4 years of basic research dealing with techno-commercial activities of different organizations like academic, corporate groups, and central government. We are fortunate to have you, sir, with us to enlighten the Indian young brain through the platform of the World of Startups. Thank you, sir, for accepting our invitation and being here today. We have with us Dr. Rajen Purohit. Sir is holding a position of Executive Dean at Ganpat University. Sir is a member of Advisory Board of Ganpat University Incubation Center and mentoring and helping many startups to grow. Sir holds the variety of experience in delivering strategies and planning of the organizational growth. He is a brand master and converted many ideas into brands so far. On behalf of the organizing committee, I welcome you, sir. We have also with us Professor Remy Mitra. She is a chairperson of Center for Entrepreneurship. The center is dedicated to foster the entrepreneurial initiatives within the Gujarat and across the India. I welcome you, ma'am. Moving further, I request Dr. Rajen Purohit to welcome the gathering. Please, sir.
Thank you very much, Dr. Saurabh Dave. Honorable Pro-Chancellor of the University, Dr. Mahendra Sharma, sir, and today's speaker, Dr. Unnat Pandit, sir. We formally, on behalf of Ganpat University, we formally welcome you for giving us your time from out of your busy schedule. And I have been updated that there are more than 400 people who are participating in this virtual webinar. And at the outset, the excited budding entrepreneurs or the students who have connected today to listen to Dr. Unnat Pandit sir, and I'm sure that at the end of the session, you will have a lot of to take home and to work upon. Today is a special day, as all of you are aware that we are based out in Gujarat. Gujarat has been known as the land of the entrepreneurs. Almost most of the renowned entrepreneurs are from Gujarat. And when we are talking about a startup or entrepreneurship or something which has to do with the business opportunities or innovation, Gujarat has a considerable contribution towards at the national level. And today is the foundation day. It's the 60th foundation day of the state of Gujarat, being the 1st May. And we are having this webinar, which will be addressed by the Pandit sir. I hope that every one of you would enjoy, you would have a great knowledge, you will disseminate that, you will apply that. Ganpat University has always been committed to create the opportunities by creating a conversed platform wherein, in the form of a TWS, wherein a speakers, an experienced veteran like Unnat Pandit sir, and investors, innovators, policymakers, governments, academics, incubators, they all come together and then they share the knowledge with the prospective or the budding entrepreneurs. And they share also the best practices with what is going on in the world, the best practices, what is going on in our beloved country. And they also help people for the opportunity mapping. So in past TWS has conducted, as a part of this TWS, many such type of a talk series have been organized, and we are committed that we will be organizing that with renowned people like Pandit sir, so that we can, you can get a benefit out of such kind of the veterans. Ganpat University also have many centers of excellences, as Dr. Saurabh Dave just mentioned. And these centers of excellences have been giving an opportunity to all our students, if they would like to come with their innovative idea, they want to pursue the exciting journey of the entrepreneurship. And we have also a very established incubation center. We are also the nodal institute for the startup appointed by Government of Gujarat. So it has been, being a socially responsible university, it has always been our priority to connect the industry, to connect the thought leaders, and to connect the visionaries, to guide and mentor persons who are people who are participating in today's webinar. I again formally extend my warm welcome to everyone who have joined from different parts of India and from outside India as well. And I wish that this will be one of the best webinars that you have attended so far as the information sharing is concerned. Thank you very much. With best wishes. Yes, over to you, Dr. Saurabh Dave. Thank you.
Thank you, sir, for your encouraging word and sparing a time to encourage the participants. Moving further, I would like to request our Honorable Pro-Chancellor and Director General, Dr. Mahendra Sarma, sir, to deliver keynote session. Please, sir.
Good afternoon, everyone. In particular, Dr. Unnit Pandit ji, we are really thankful to you for making it convenient to address this important webinar on startup ecosystem in the country. I am equally delighted by the presence of my team and those who are able to get connected to this webinar. As has been said and has been discussed about Ganpat University, but before that, I would like to congratulate all the people from Gujarat and Maharashtra. 1st of May is the establishment foundation day of both the states, state of Gujarat as well as the state of Maharashtra. Gujarat is celebrating its 68th foundation day. The state which has given us father of the nation, Mahatma Gandhi, Iron Man of India, Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel, and the most dynamic Prime Minister which the country has ever seen, Honorable Shri Narendra Bhai Modi ji. What else can be said? We are a university from his home district. He belongs to Mehsana, and we are the only university in his home district. And it would be a great insight to Unnit Pandit ji also. He has addressed our convocation in 2009 as the then Chief Minister of the state. And when we were looking at our historical photo collections, we found that when we were doing Bhumi Pujan way back in 1996 on the land, Shri Narendra Bhai attended the Bhumi Pujan. And we could identify him sitting then with the then Chief Minister Keshubhai Patel. So we belong to the home district, and it was Narendra Bhai's suggestion that Gujarat has the biggest coastline and none of the universities has B.Tech in marine. And we started marine engineering with the approval of Director General of Shipping. And we are still the only marine engineering college of the entire state of Gujarat, which has the biggest coastline of the country. And Director General of Shipping has given us A1 grade, which is outstanding since last 7 years. It was Narendra Bhai's suggestion that we start an army school for girls way back in 2007. So at that point of time, Gujarat had one school in Balachadi, army school for boys. There was no Sainik school for girls. So we took up that initiative also, and we established the second Sainik school for girls in the country at Ganpat Vidyanagar. So as I was telling you, and then when he became the Prime Minister and Government of Japan and Government of India signed an agreement to establish Japan-India Institute of Manufacturing. The first Japan-India Institute of Manufacturing is housed at Ganpat University. And Suzuki Motors, under its CSR, has invested 20 crore rupees. And it is the only university which has an automobile assembly line where cars are assembled by the students. So the reason why I am narrating to you is under the leadership of a very innovative, enterprising Prime Minister, and the university also has got those characteristics. Apart from coming from the founders, Ganpat Bhai Patel, Padma Shri Ganpat Bhai Patel, whom all we lovingly call Dada, is a rags to riches story. and he is the only Indian who is on the board of regents of University of California and has been in the 100-year history of University of California, has been given the best alumni, and recently, 1 month back, concluded a board meeting. They have also awarded him honorary doctorate. Dada has been a very innovative and experimentative person, and he created a company, Cherokee Incorporation, and started manufacturing power chips and became so successful in a short period of 10 years that his company was the world's most profitable company, with employing more than 3,000 people in the 80s. So we have those characteristics in our DNA coming from our founders, philanthropists who supported us, and the type of people who are engaged with this entire ecosystem of Ganpat University. Having said so, we are living in a world which people call, given the corona situation also, it's a VUCA world. It is volatile, uncertain, complex, ambiguous. And I am coming across terminologies now. People are using the term BC and AC. They say before corona and after corona, life will not be same. The way people are living won't be same. The way businesses was done will not remain same. Practices will change. And in this process of BC and AC, there are new opportunities which are emerging. That is redesigning the organizations, opportunities of redoing the entire thing, de-learning certain things, relearning certain things, and coming up with newer models. So it was rightly said years back when it was said that institutions can't build the future for the young, but they can build the young for the future. So it is always the right time to kickstart a new thought process with the young generation. I understand running a university that any world-class institution we talk about has a seamless integration of education, research and innovation. Education primarily disseminates knowledge, research creates new knowledge, and innovation converts knowledge into wealth and social goods. For example, let us take Cambridge University. Cambridge University has won over 80 Nobel Prizes, but at the same time has 15,000 startups, which created nearly 45,000 jobs with at least five companies with revenues of $1 billion. So we are seeing universities. Universities, unlike in Indian setups, now after the Honorable Prime Minister took over, the gap between the industry, government and the universities have reduced. And now universities are actively engaged into all three components of educating, research and innovation. Earlier, it was left to specialized people to do the job. Now, each university, which has a fair quantity of intellectual capacity, has started working in all three domains and has started integrating with the top institutions within the nation and globally also. But if you look at any of these foreign universities over the years, they have successfully done it. And what we found was the enterprises of today all originated basically from the universities. The ideas originated from there. I am reminded of Bill Gates. The reason is Bill Gates, when he was invited for one of the speeches at a Harvard University commencement, he spoke about what were his feelings when he was still a student in a courier house hostel. He was still there, and he was trying to write a software. So I recall reading from his text that one of the biggest memories of Harvard came in January 1975 when I made a call from courier house to a company that had begun making the world's first personal computers. I offered to sell them software. I was worried that they would realize I was just a student in a dorm and would hang up on me. Instead, they said, "We are not quite ready. Come see us in a month," which was a good thing because we hadn't written the software yet. From that moment, I worked day and night on this little extra credit project that marked the end of my college education, and that was the beginning of a remarkable journey with Microsoft. This tells us the importance of trust. When we are talking about an ecosystem, When we are talking about looking at countries like Israel, which are termed as the startup nation of the world, it is a similar story here that we are full of young people. The first and the foremost important component that the ecosystem, when we talk about universities, when we talk about industries, when we talk about government, is the basic component of trust that should evolve. The methodologies and the approaches should build that trust. And what I can foresee in last 4 or 5 years, a lot of effort has gone in ever since our Honorable Prime Minister, if I look at the dateline, our Honorable Prime Minister announced from the Red Fort on August 15, 2015, if I am right, about Startup and Stand-Up India policy and the thought process. And Finance Minister at that point of time was quick enough to respond with 2,000 crore India Aspiration Fund. SIDBI announced Smile with an investment of rupees 10,000 crore. Atal Innovation Mission and Self-Employment and Talent Utilization was launched at that point of time. The number of projected startups were about 11,500 by 2020, if I am right. Dr. Pandit would be the best man to comment on it. These are the data which I could collect. And NESCOM was also fast enough to respond, and they had set an ambitious initiative of establishing 10,000 startups. And the program which NESCOM launched was supported by Microsoft, Google, Intel, Kotak, and so many people came forward. Everybody was trying to handhold this important initiative. But Indian universities' methodologies, their approaches to education were still rudimentary. So what was needed was to experiment by changing the education methodologies and patterns that would instigate inquisitiveness, start idea competitions, engaging students into more action projects, projects where they were actually looking at innovative ideas and gaps in the industry. They could understand the problems. In true sense, university methodologies started working towards creating knowledge workers. We had been talking about it a lot within university setups across the state and the country, and there was a lot of deliberation. Initially, the universities used to discuss, if I remember, 90s and the early 20s, we were only talking about employment. We never talked about entrepreneurship. So it was like, knowledge, and from knowledge the skills will give him the job, and that is what was the thought process prevailing in the universities. But today, in last 5 years, there is a change. Universities have brought in within the content important subject called entrepreneurship, management of innovations, and it is being taught in each and every professional course being offered. Now there are idea competitions happening. Universities have established startup centers, incubation centers, centers for entrepreneurship. And now there is an ecosystem which is being created. But then the availability of people who can do the right hand-holding in terms of guiding them properly was the initial missing link. But thanks to the corporate CII, FICCI, SOCHAM, industry bodies in Gujarat, GCCI, we look at a lot of effort coming from industrialists who started handholding and started mentoring on a personal without any kind of taking back anything. They started handholding. So slowly and gradually, some ecosystem is evolving, but still we need to do a lot on that front. Government has been doing a lot. They have been really helping with a lot of funds. In Gujarat, Gujarat government is giving a good quantum of money, but then it is like incubating the idea, but the next level still needs a lot of support and a think through into policies. We have to work on the trust part, and we have to ensure that India, I remember in one of the conferences we were attending, and it has been talked in several conferences also, that India has always been termed as a land of idea, and India remained a land of ideas, US and Europe remained the land of opportunities. But now with the effort which the government is trying to put in and the type of ecosystem which is being tried to build to cushion startups, probably the day is not far almost it is here, and probably after corona effect would be for India, the best effect would be that we are going to be the land of opportunities. Anyway, our Honorable Prime Minister has already signaled a few days back that all the Chinese businesses, all the businesses who are housed in China, they need to move out, and we need to gear up to attract them to India. In the Chief Minister's deliberation, and it was published in newspapers, and he has given us this clear indication that now the effort should move in a direction that innovations are also taking place. At the same time, universities and other ecosystems should start handholding and working in that direction where we can bring those businesses, attract those businesses to India. So these are era, apart from the challenges of corona, the opportunities which it is bringing, we need to gear up to take up those opportunities. And it was like our late Prime Minister Atal Bihari Vajpayee Saab used to say, the real future of India lies in IT. And people thought it was information technology, but it was not information technology, it was Indian talent. And that is what our Honorable Prime Minister at that point meant. And today, when Satyam Shivam Sundaram are ruling the world, and each and every top global company is headed by an Indian, we have really proven our mettle, and we are going to take up this opportunity. So the saying that it was great to be an Indian, now people will say it is great to be in India. And recently in some newspapers also I came across a lot of foreign country wants their nationals to come back to their country, but they are not ready to go. They feel safer in India, even in corona situation. So we are doing our best, and it's the right time that the deliberation is happening, and guidance from people who are experiencing, who are actually guiding this, like Dr. Unnat Pandit. It would be extremely important that the participants would get right kind of insight, and we are doing it at the right time. We have all the time to conceptualize, to start working, and to take the maximum benefit of all the opportunities which are emerging. With those words, I would like to thank everyone for patient hearing. In particular, I am really thankful to Dr. Unnat Pandit and making it possible to address this important webinar. And the last word of caution to everyone, stay home, stay safe, follow government guidelines, and try to teach others also to strictly follow government guidelines. Thank you.
Thank you, sir, for inspiring word and encouragement in such a unique time. I'm sure the attendees will benefit out of this entire learning. Moving further, I would like to invite Professor Remy for a quick briefing on the Center for Entrepreneurship.
Good afternoon, everyone. Thank you, Professor Dave. Let me just share my slide. Professor Dave, I hope the screen is visible. Okay. Ganpat University has an exclusive center for entrepreneurship, which is dedicated to ignite the spirit of entrepreneurship and offer a basket of opportunities across all verticals, with key focus on startup founders and entrepreneurs. Ganpat University is offering an exclusive MBA for startup and entrepreneurship. It's a full-time 2 year postgraduate program. This course offers exclusive subjects including business opportunity, design thinking, risk assessment, enterprise scalability, diversification, and lot more. Here, we have a system of learning process called as milestone-based learnings, where students achieve different milestones in span of 2 years so that they can come up with ideas, convert them into prototype, do its market survey, and finally convert them into a full-fledged business. Also, we have our own in-house incubation center, which has been supported by Student Startup Innovation Policy, Government of Gujarat. From here, we can expect and support for initiation as well as prototype grants. We also have one more program which is focusing on postgraduate diploma in entrepreneurship with key focus on startups and entrepreneurs. This gives a hands-on training right from finding the right idea to formulating products and services to engaging with various stakeholders, including vendors, all in a period of 1 year timeline. For more information, you can contact me. My number is also given. I'm Professor Remy Mitra, or you can even visit the university website. Thank you so much for listening me. Stay tuned and enjoy the webinar.
Thank you, Professor Remy. Now the time came. We all are eager, excited to get enlightened from Dr. Pandit. We have our today's eminent speaker, our today's keynote speaker, Dr. Pandit. So over to you, sir. The audience is waiting for you.
Thank you. Thank you very much. How long I have a time? Let me again map this.
Sir,
how much time can I take?
We have 40 minutes of a session we have scheduled.
Okay. So up to 40 minutes I can run this.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Just a minute. Let me. I'm trying to share my screen. Can you see my screen?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So the PPT is visible?
Yes, sir, very much.
Yeah. So thank you very much for such a enlightening interaction which I am going to have. Before I begin my talk, I have got the questions. 7 questions I have already responded, and a few more questions, queries are also expected. This is the temper which we are having, and startup innovation ecosystem is going to build the new India. And before I begin my talk, I would like to thank the Ganpat University management and the incubation ecosystem leaders of the Ganpat University for organizing such a wonderful interactive session over a webinar. And definitely today is a special day. Today is the Gujarat Foundation Day, and being Gujarati, I also feel proud for today's Gujarat Foundation Day, and I convey my best wishes to all the Gujarati. Jai Jai Garvi Gujarat. So Gujarat is a land of entrepreneurship, and it's there in the genes of each and every citizens of Gujarat. And while we are talking in today's point that opportunities for building startup ecosystem in India, I have added few more statements into this with an aim of advancement in rural societies and communities in tier 2, tier 3 cities. If we can make a difference in the lives of rural societies and communities staying in tier 2, tier 3 city, what kind of advancement which we can do it? And when I say this, the three word which comes to me as a prompt, challenges which we are facing. The first one is to ideate. Second one is to deploy. And third one is transformation. Ideate, when I mean that our innovation should really address the need of society, rural societies, communities staying in tier 2, tier 3 cities. They are not much at the advancement of all the technological development which can address their needs. So focus of the innovation building and startup ecosystem should be towards that aspect also. And those who have an opportunity to innovate and have a focus on this target audience, they have something which is a unique call deployment opportunities. They are going to absorb your innovation, and by successful deployment you are not only going to achieve your sustainability, but you will have a pride of transformation of society and building the ecosystem where nothing is in existence. Startup and innovation ecosystem deployment and utilizing the public funded research as well is important for all of us. And while I have thought of giving you a quick snapshot of innovation mission is doing and how in a different phases we have launched a different initiatives. Innovation cycle in the bottom is clearly visible to everyone, that aim is catering the need of all aspiring innovator starting from their ideation journey to the large scale commercialization. And our different initiatives are taking care of a different phase of the innovation and startup ecosystem. Starting from Atal Tinkering Lab, which is creating the young minds towards innovating. And so far we have selected 8,878 schools, which represent 90%+ districts of our country. And it offers the problem identification and design thinking opportunity, exposure to learn the futuristic technology platform and utilize it for identifying the solutions. Atal Incubation Center is another such initiative which works on the startups or aspiring innovators who have the basic prototype ready and would like to explore the productization and the startup journey and how they can be a sustainable startup and proceed towards a large scale commercial support to the market. So entire backbone ecosystem is getting established through incubation center. This was the phase one. In phase two, we have launched another two challenges and another two initiatives, wherein all the researchers, innovators, small enterprises, MSMEs can come forward and address the challenges being faced by India, wherein we have collaborated with various ministries, department, PSU, even various agencies who have a grassroots challenges in serving the society. And for them, we have thought that how we can cater the need of the core society and how their problems can be addressed through innovative technology and scientific advancement. And in a phase one, we have launched Atal New India Challenges 1.0, wherein we have launched 24 such challenges, and at the end of a rigorous screening process, from 900 applicants, we could able to select 26 applicants in 13 challenges. For 12 challenges, we could not able to find the suitable solution provider as well, or a suitable innovation which can really address the need. So it's a time for working on the basics and understand the grassroots of where the problem lies and understanding the challenges rather than quickly jumping onto the solution. And those 26 winners are going to get a grantinet support from Atal Innovation Mission once this lockdown phase is going to get open. They are currently fulfilling the compliance process and they will get the grantinet worth of rupees 1 crore. Up to 1 crore they will be getting. And secondly, they will also get the opportunity to attract the external funding, which will help them towards ensuring their sustainability in the startup value of death. The another initiative which is fairly new and soon the major details will come into the public domain is Atal Research and Innovation for Small Enterprises. Wherein again here, the small enterprises, MSMEs, researchers and innovators will collaborate, will identify the right solution. And if the challenge is not listed in Atal New India Challenges, they can still come forward with to Atal Innovation Mission, make a submission of their challenge and how their innovative solution can address the societal need. So irrespective of that, the challenge is listed or not, if they feel that this is a societal challenge and they can address this, then group of experts and the committee consisting of various officials and the expert professionals will evaluate their application, will call them for the presentation, and then based on the quality interaction between the applicant and the screening of selection committee, they will jointly take a call. And the phase 3, which is fairly new, where we have thought of coordinating and governance into the ecosystem building. And that's where we have jumped in and we have explored the establishment of an Atal Community Innovation Center, specifically in Tier 2, Tier 3 cities, and where the unserved, underserved region is lying, and how their engagement, involvement can really catalyze the need of the country. And this is what the journey of Atal Innovation Mission. For any startup, if they need to really ensure the success of their journey, then I again quote the statement by Sri R. A. Marshalkar, former Director General of CSIR, who rightly pointed out to explore the innovation research coming out of mind, to explore deployment into the market, mind to market. So for doing it so, you need to think more and change more. And for doing it, this diagram will explain you what exactly is the need. The current youth is having curiosity and their thought process is rapid, and their skills of adopting the knowledge, adopting the technology and exploring the solution driving force is much more, and they are quickly designing the rapid solutions. But here I again make a caution that knowledge dynamics play the important role. I am going to discuss more on this in my coming slides. Later, they need to explore the execution, lab scale, pilot scale, commercial scale, and ensure that your product or services are eco-friendly. And IP management is also required to be ensured. And with this, you have to make sure that your solutions are eco-friendly, your solutions are managing within the services which is being expected. Now on global fora, this is something which is a global innovation index and innovation output. And parameters or index, we can see grossly imbalance into the input tool and the output tool. So it's a high time for all of us to work on this. And if we foresee that in COVID challenges, India on GII ranking is on a 52nd position. And many established ecosystems who are a front runner since many years are among the top 15-20 innovation countries. The way COVID-19 has impacted them and the way COVID-19 has impacted India, you can see whatever the advancement which they have taken up, that was completely helpless. Even they are relying on India for the basic ventilators which has been designed by our startups and our small medium enterprises. So this is the power of innovation. Now serving the community through innovation and technology driven solution means rejuvenating the inherent innovative culture among the community in India, empowering the communities to ideate and bring the change. So your youth and students need to be empowered enough towards free flow of information related to community, ideate, bring the change through their ideation. No matter whatsoever may be the big idea, it always start with the small. Gujarat's industry tycoon, the Ambani Group, has established the initiative or Reliance Industries or Reliance Empire, even by selling the pakoda in a small place called Chorwad. He was having big ideas and big ideas he was trying to implement, but his journey started with small. This is the mindset which plays the important role. Transforming and scaling up idea into the market and market ready product services can build the entire ecosystem. Making India world's technology leader in 21st century is more important, and we must ensure that India achieves the glory which India deserves, and India should be planning to take a world leadership position in innovation startup ecosystem. Now, in order to do it so, what shall we will be doing? Through innovation and technology driven solution, we need to clearly design the challenges to get impactful solution. So the institution like Ganpati University need to identify the right challenges at institutional level and give the ideation challenges to the students towards designing the impactful solution. And with the systematic screening process, the idea which qualifies the further advancement, we can further nurture the researchers, innovators to scale up their solution and deploy this solution in the area of societal importance. And that's how the design thinking process in student will spur the creativity, which is already in existence to all the students. And by doing it so, we are going to improve on the output goal which we are having. Now, I would like to take few examples. See, everybody is thinking that COVID-19 is a big challenge and big opportunity. But post COVID-19, how many such innovative solutions are going to be adopted by the world leaders? So big pharma, healthcare industries are behind this innovations and healthcare challenges to be addressed. Even though there is a huge scope for the startups in the small ancillary area, if their solution is niche, then they have a true potential. And beside that, would like to put it forward certain specific challenges related to the infectious diseases. Overall, vector-borne diseases account for more than 70% of all infectious diseases. Novel coronavirus is fairly new. It has affected the huge population across the globe, but this vector-borne diseases are also killing more than 7 lakh people annually. So this is clear-cut a thrust area wherein if we can address some innovative solution, there is a room to address this societal challenge. More than 3.9 billion people over 128 countries are at risk of contracting with the dengue, and 96 billion cases estimated per year in India. So this is what the challenges which we clear-cut facing. Just I have thought of putting up some economics where 95% of Indian population is at the risk of malaria. And just the people who are having malarial symptoms or causing malaria, they need to off their economic activity. So at least for 1 or 2 weeks, they will be off their commercial engagement. Just the burden of this disease, I have tried to correlate with the economic burden for that particular disease in India. And while scanning through the literature and with the source of WHO Southeast Asia, Asian Journal of Public Health, I have found that 13,600 crore worth of revenue loss is just because of malaria. Same way dengue is 1.3 million, the latest figure, and cases in 213 districts in 15 states. Same way waterborne diseases, 3.7 million Indians are affected by waterborne diseases, 1.5 million child die of diarrhea, which needs a basic ORS goal. So minerals, so that demineralization can be stopped during the diarrhea. And this is a huge opportunity for startup if they have a flavored some minerals which can be delivered to the needy people. People are offering the codes and artificial flavors, but India needs such a health drinks where even during the disease condition or during the normal days also they can explore utilization of this cold drinks. India's GDP expenditure, I have tried to compare with the various countries. So we don't have a liberty of spending huge amount on research and innovation. So whatsoever the resources which is available to us, we need to utilize effectively, and we need to ensure that the utilization results into commercially successful innovation where we have the IP. And this is the quick snapshot why startups are failing. Startups are identifying solutions where no market need is there. And major thrust is that whatever the idea which is getting populated in their mind, they are trying to deploy without understanding the market need. Or they are in the solution which is not timely, or solution is too much costly. Pricing is such a huge product without the business strategy, customers and their feedback. Please focus on the target where the problem is and where your solution is offered. And definitely pivot gone bad. Whatever the assumptions they have taken it, that assumptions are ruining the entire cash flow or their outcomes, their nation. If I would, fintech has a 42% of the failure, so on an average ranging for 40 to 60%. ICT sector has a higher failure rate. Construction sector has a two less of the startup, but whatsoever the startups they have, among that more than is the mining sector. A small number, but not everybody has the opportunity. Success top five sectors. It timely if you are offering your truly and business model if funding is sufficient, then you can a few hotbed sectors which I foresee post COVID-19. The corporate wellness services, which is again going to change the entire industry. Human resource and benefits, meaning benefits which corporate would like to offer, like health, wellness, social diagnosis, and personal care. This will get the opportunity of serving or gaining the cutting edge against COVID-19 and scientific and economic service consulting. So into more consulting, those who are going to offer consulting, they will have the opportunity as well. Relaxation beverages. I would again, relaxation beverages, the healthy tonic and healthy mineralizing beverages, not the soft drink or artificial. Street vendors improving the supply and delivery through digital intervention. Recently, even the WhatsApp, the Facebook, and the Jio tie-up is going to catalyze this. And they have already announced institutional framework to support the small vendors as well. And this is what it is going to foresee, that will have the opportunity. Organic food consumers are always going to have the importance. Society's behavior is going to get changed to have useful. And food is always going to have the importance for next 5 to 10 years. On smart solutions through IT interventions, ICT intervention, social networking, games development. So India's dependency high on the overseas gaming sector, contributing to the Indian need. And clear-cut social networking, according to the societal need and domestic need, is going to have the future prospect. Training and learning through a gaming is again going to be the new sector which is going to get built. People are trying to maintain the social distancing, and all training learning through gaming will have the opportunity. Internet publishing and broadcasting again will have the cutting edge. And for offering such niche, UI UX solution provider will have the support of MSME and the SME sector who can take up the services from this service provider. Online survey of the software, service provider, domestic e-commerce, online auction. There is a big list of these services which they can really offer. Data storage and cybersecurity is again going to be one of the sector. Networking service and digital solution is again going to be the huge opportunity. So it's time for brainstorming within the teams, within the mentor and the startups, how they would like to explore the opportunity and how they would like to foresee the support to the rural societies and the communities staying in tier 2, tier 3 cities, and how they foresee that their solution is meeting to the societal need. And with this brainstorming, I would like to take a pause, and whatsoever the questions and answers which you have, do let me know in your Q&A, and accordingly I will try to answer your questions and queries.
So the session is open for the Q&A. Anybody has a question can drop the chat box. Unnat sir, aapnu mic mute hai.
Yeah, I was having one more WebEx at 4 o'clock, so I have told them I'm going to join in few minutes.
So, I guess, sir, you have already answered all the questions from the participants. Later on, if anybody has it, we will drop an email and compile it and send it to you, sir.
So, this question, when I have got it, is related to you. Can we get a recording of this lecture? It is up to you. What is the definition of a startup as per Niti Aayog? See, Himanshu, I have answered all your questions which you have posed during the initial phase of this. Startup definition is standard as dictated by the DPIIT, and that's the standard terminology which is adopted all across the government system. Now, which kind of startups or institutions are to be supported?
Ananya, maybe you can zoom in the slides.
How they have to be supported, that's again.
Yeah, let me know when I should start. So hi everybody.
Sorry for the intervention. So how they should be supported is all within this particular institutional framework who will decide this. But terminology is same, definition is same all across the government system. Share some idea about Gujarat CM announced yesterday for the event from 1st May to 10th May. You need to give more clarity on the kind of event. I may not be able to share my views without knowing much into this. Maybe you need to throw some more light on this kind of a question. Almost all other questions are too general, which I have covered in my talk. So thank you very much for such a useful and interactive session, and I appreciate the way Ganpati University has taken up this initiative to offer the discussion on opportunities for the startups in the COVID-19 scenario.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir, for sparing a valuable time and make it available yourself to enlighten the startup ecosystem. For the attendees, I would like to tell that the entire session is live on Facebook, and we will also share the post recorded YouTube link to everyone. Sir, we will compile the entire Q&A. If anybody has a post session question answer required, we'll compile some questions and send it to you, sir. Thank you
very much.
Thank you, sir, for joining enlightening the audience. Thank you, Rajan Purohit, sir. Thank you, our Honorable Director General, sir, for joining it. Thank you, Professor Remy, for joining and briefing about the Center for Entrepreneurship. This ends our today's session. Thank you, everyone. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.